Good morning all. Hope you studied the properties of inverse trigonometric functions. So today we are going to do some problems by using those properties. Ready? Okay. So first one problem is given. Prove that sine inverse x is equal to cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square. That is equal to tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square. We need to prove cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square is equal to sin inverse of x, and tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square also sin inverse of x. So first we can take this one. Sin inverse x equal to cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square. We can start from RHS. See the RHS side. Cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square. See, this one we need to prove it as sin inverse of x, isn't it? Cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square. If we are getting inside the, see the outer function is cos inverse. If we are getting this inside the bracket, this expression as cos x, we can write cos inverse of cos x equal to x. We can use that result. So, can you make this root of 1 minus x square as cos x by using suitable substitution? Cos x or cos theta, anything. Cos inverse of cos of something. What we can do, what substitution we can give for x to make it as cos, root of 1 minus x square should be cos. So if you are substituting x equal to sin theta, x equal to sin theta, what we will get? This will become cos inverse of root of 1 minus sin square theta. Correct now? Our right side will become cos inverse of root of 1 minus sin square theta. So this is equal to cos inverse of root of 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta. So we are getting root of cos square theta. So this is equal to cos inverse of root of cos square means cos theta. So we got cos inverse of cos theta, that is equal to theta. What is theta? X equal to sin theta, which implies theta equal to sin inverse of x. So this is equal to sin inverse of x. So we got the LHS side. Clear? Then next. Next we need to prove tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square is also sin inverse of x. We can take RHS, that is tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square. So, see, this is two question. Sin inverse of x equal to cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square is one question. Sin inverse of x equal to tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square is the another question. Clear? So what we can do here? Tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square. Here the outer function is tan inverse. And we need to get inside the bracket. Inside the bracket as a rational function. If we are getting this as tan of something, it is easy for us. Suppose this we are getting it as tan theta. Then we can write tan inverse of tan theta is equal to theta. Isn't it? So what substitution we can give for this one? This x. Root of x. See, tan, to get this as tan theta, we need to get it as sin theta by cos theta. Means it is given in rational function form. Sin theta by cos theta. So, we understood x, we need to substitute x is equal to sin theta. Then it is easy for us to prove this result. Isn't it? So, put x equal to sin theta in this expression. So, our right side will become tan inverse of sin theta divided by root of 1 minus sin square theta. Correct? So this is equal to tan inverse of sin theta divided by root of 1 minus sin square theta is 1 minus sin square theta is cos square theta. Root of 1 minus sin square theta is root of cos square theta. So, cos theta. If you need, you can write more steps. It means root of 1 minus sin square theta, you can write in the next step, it is cos square theta. Root of cos square theta means cos theta. So, we got like this. So, it is equal to tan inverse of tan theta. So, we are getting it is equal to theta. Clear? What is theta? X equal to sin theta. So, theta equal to sin inverse of x. We got the left hand side. See this one? Or another way we can do the same question. What we have to prove here? Sin inverse of x equal to cos inverse of something is equal to tan inverse of something. So, let us take sin inverse of x equal to some theta. Sin inverse of x is equal to theta. Okay. So, what we can write? Sin theta is equal to x. Let us consider one right angle triangle. This is given theta. Sin theta equal to x. Sin theta means what? Opposite by hypotenuse. So, we can take this as x and hypotenuse as 1. X by 1. X. Sin theta equal to x is given. So, what will come this adjacent side? Root of 1 minus x square. Correct, no? From that triangle, we can write cos theta. Cos theta is equal to adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. So, it will come root of 1 minus x square. So, we got theta is equal to cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square. Correct. Then we can write tan theta. What is tan theta from the figure? Opposite by adjacent. We are getting x by root of 1 minus x square. From this one we can write theta is equal to tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square. See this one? We got theta equal to sin inverse of x, theta equal to cos inverse of root of 1 minus x square, theta equal to tan inverse of x by root of 1 minus x square. So, we got this result. Clear? Okay. The next question. Prove that 3 sin inverse of x is equal to sin inverse of 3x minus 4x cube. See this question. We need to prove sin inverse of 3x minus 4x cube is equal to 3 sin inverse of x. Same way you will think. Means like previous question. See this one. Sin inverse of 3x minus 4x cube. Here the outer function is sin inverse. So, if we are able to get that inside the bracket as sin theta, we will be able to write theta. Sin inverse of sin theta will come. It is easy for us to write theta. So, what substitution will make that as sin of something? Did you see this expression before? 3x minus 4x cube in trigonometry, this structure. Yes, sin 3 theta. What is sin 3 theta? Sin 3 theta is equal to 3 sin theta minus 4 sin cube theta. So, we can substitute x equal to sin theta. That means sin inverse of x is equal to some theta or x is equal to sin theta. Clear? X equal to sin theta we can substitute. Then we can start from RHS. Right side is equal to sin inverse of 3x minus 4x cube, that is equal to sin inverse of 3 sin theta minus 4 sin cube theta. We substituted x equal to sin theta. So, we are getting sin inverse of sin 3 theta. Clear? So, it is 3 theta. Sin inverse of sin 3 theta is 3 theta. What is theta? 3 into sin inverse of x. We reach the LHS side. Is it okay for you? The next problem. Prove that 3 cos inverse x is equal to cos inverse of 4x cube minus 3x. See here the right side, cos inverse of 4x cube minus 3x. What we can give 4x to get in the bracket means this expression 4x cube minus 3x cube as cos of something. We can substitute x equal to cos theta. So put x equal to cos theta in the right side. Cos theta. So right side will come cos inverse of 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. So this is equal to cos inverse of what is 4 cos cube theta minus cos 3 cos theta? Cos 3 theta. That's why we selected x equal to cos theta to write it as cos of 3 theta. So this is coming cos 3 theta. Cos 3 theta's expansion is given 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta. So we can write it as 3 theta. So this is equal to 3 into x equal to cos theta. So theta equal to cos inverse of x. So this is equal to right left side. See this result. Means we given the proof. Okay. Then see. We have written one step like this. Cos inverse of cos of 3 theta as 3 theta. Actually when it is possible. When we can write as equal to 3 theta. Cos inverse of cos x equal to x. When x belongs to the principal value branch. That means 3 theta belongs to. 3 theta belongs to 0 pi. 0 pi is the principal value branch of cos inverse function. So 3 theta must be in between 0 and pi. That means 0 less than or equal to 3 theta less than or equal to pi. So we can write 0 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 3. Theta varies from 0 to pi by 3. So x varies from theta means cos theta is x. So theta is equal to cos inverse of x. When theta varies from 0 to pi by 3 means cos inverse of x varies from 0, 1 by 2 to cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2, 1 by 2 to 1, cos 0 is 1. So from 1 by 2 to 1 x varies. So actually with this question we will get x belongs to 1 by 2, 1 in the interval 1 by 2, 1. That time only this result holds. Otherwise, if x belongs to any other interval other than 1 by 2 and 1 means outer of that interval, then this result does not hold. Clear? See, same situation happened in the previous case also. What we wrote, the sine inverse of sine 3 theta is equal to sine 3 theta. We wrote it is equal to 3 theta. Actually, when it is clear, when it is correct, when 3 theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. That means 3 theta must be in the interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Correct? That means minus pi by 2 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 2. Sorry, 3 theta. Then divide by 3, we are getting minus pi by 6 less than or equal to theta less than or equal to pi by 6. Theta varies from minus pi by 6 to plus pi by 6. That means the value x varies from minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2. Sin pi by 6 means 30 degree. Sin 30 degree is 1 by 2. Sin minus 30 degree is minus 1 by 2. Clear? So minus 1 by 2 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1 by 2. So in this range, when x belongs to minus 1 by 2 to plus 1 by 2, that time only the previous question holds. The previous inequality holds. Clear? Actually, these results, which are the problems we did, these results you have to study as a property. Then you, if you are getting a situation to apply, you can use that property. Okay. So next question. Simplify. Tan inverse of root of 1 minus cos x divided by 1 plus cos x. Okay. What is 1 minus cos x?
We know 1 minus cos x is equal to 2 sin square x by 2.
We studied the result in plus 1.
1 plus cos x is equal to 2 cos square x by 2. This result we know already.
So apply that result, simplification.
So tan inverse of root of 1 minus cos x divided by 1 plus cos x will come tan inverse of root of 2 sin square x by 2 by 2 cos square x by 2. Direct
result we are giving for 1 minus cos x and 1 plus cos x. So we are getting tan inverse of 2, 2 cancelled. Sin square x by 2 by cos square x by 2 is tan square x by 2.
So we are getting root of tan square x by 2.
So this is equal to tan inverse of tan x by 2.
Root of tan square means tan x by 2.
So we are getting the answer is equal to x by 2. So simplified form of that question answer is x by 2. Tan inverse of root of 1 minus cos x by 1 plus cos x is equal to x by 2. Clear? Then next, simplify itself.
Tan inverse of 3a square x minus x cube divided by a cube minus 3a x square.
We got one question to simplify. Clear? What we know? See, inside we need to get a tan of something, then we can simplify easily. Means tan inverse of tan of something, that something only will come. Isn't it? What is the result for tan theta? It's look like tan theta. See, 3 minus 6 x cube means 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by 1 minus 3 tan square theta is tan 3 theta. So we can write tan 3 theta is equal to, means we know tan 3 theta's result. Tan 3 theta is equal to 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by 1 minus 3 tan square theta.
So if you are giving x is equal to tan theta, 3 a square tan theta minus tan cube theta, like this it will come. So a square will be there. Means here also a cube is there, a is there.
So we need to eliminate a also. So what substitution we can give for x? X is equal to, we need to cancel this a. We can substitute x equal to a tan theta.
So put x equal to a tan theta. A tan theta.
Then our question will come like this. Tan inverse of 3a square into a tan theta minus a tan cube theta. A tan theta whole cube divided by a cube minus 3a into a tan theta whole square.
Then it is coming tan inverse of a square into a cube. Here also a cube. So on the numerator we are getting one a cube as common factor. 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by, denominator here a cube, in the second term a into a square, so a cube we are getting again as common factor in from the denominator, 1 minus 3 tan square theta.
Then see, tan inverse of a cube cancelled. 3 tan theta minus tan cube theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta, directly we can write as tan 3 theta.
So our next step, tan inverse of tan 3 theta. This expression is tan 3 theta's expansion. Tan inverse of tan 3 theta is 3 theta. What is x, x equal to a tan theta. So tan theta is equal to x by a. So what will come? Theta. Don't write your final answer in terms of theta, because theta we just introduced to solve the problem, isn't it? So convert this theta into x and a's form. Theta is equal to tan theta equal to x by a means theta equal to tan inverse of x by a. So we are getting 3 into tan inverse of x by a. Correct. So we got the simplified form. Okay. Next one question. This is very important problem. Means like this question we are getting for examination. Okay. Prove that cos inverse of 4 by 5 plus cos inverse of 12 by 13 equal to cos inverse of 33 by 65. See, cos inverse of 4 by 5 plus cos inverse of 12 by 13 is equal to cos inverse of something, isn't it? We didn't study cos inverse of x plus cos inverse of y, something like that we didn't study. But we studied tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y. Tan, what is tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y? Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. Clear? Then, so we need to change this cos inverse of 4 by 5 in terms of tan inverse of something. For that actually what we need to do? We need to take cos inverse of 4 by 5 is equal to some theta. So cos 4 by 5 is equal to, sorry, cos theta is equal to 4 by 5. Then intent you studied by using identity, you can find sin theta, then sin theta by cos theta tan theta, then you are getting theta equal to tan inverse of something. Like that you can do. Or another way we can do. Consider one triangle. Right angle triangle. Mark one angle as theta. Cos theta. Sorry. Theta equal to cos inverse of 4 by 5. So cos theta equal to 4 by 5. Cos theta equal to 4 by 5. Adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. Then what you are getting here? Here 4 and hypotenuse 5, so this side is 3. So it is easy for us to write tan inverse. What is theta then? Tan inverse of 3 by 4. Cos inverse of 4 by 5 is theta. Tan inverse of 3 by 4 also theta. So cos inverse of 4 by 5 we can directly write tan inverse of 3 by 4. Plus, in this triangle, means second term, we can write again another one triangle, theta, instead of theta phi, we can use phi, another one angle. Cos inverse of 12 by 13 is phi, let us take like this. So, cos phi is equal to 12 by 13. Then what will come this side? Altitude, height will come phi. 13 square minus 12 square, that is 25. So root 25 is 5. So from this triangle we can write tan inverse of 5 is equal to tan inverse of 5 by 12. I think you got the idea. Cos inverse of 4 by 5 is in this triangle, it is theta. That same theta we can write in terms of tan inverse. So tan inverse of 3 by 4. Tan theta is 3 by 4. When cos theta is equal to 4 by 5, tan theta equal to 3 by 4. So theta equal to tan inverse of 3 by 4. And from the second triangle we are getting cos inverse of 12 by 13 is 5. That is same as tan inverse of 5 by 12. So we changed cos inverse into tan inverse. Then see tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y form. What is tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of y? We studied last day. Tan inverse of x plus y divided by 1 minus xy. So apply this result. Tan inverse of x plus y means 3 by 4 plus 5 by 12 divided by 1 minus xy. X is 3 by 4 into 5 by 12. So this is equal to tan inverse of, add this one, LCM is 48. So, or you can make this as 3 into 3 into 3. 3 3s are 9, 9 plus 5, 14. Or you can take cross multiplication method, that is easy because denominator here also 48 is coming. So 12 into 3, 36 plus 20 divided by 48 by 1 minus, or this is coming 48, 48 minus 3 5s are 15 divided by 48. So by 48 cancel, we are getting it as tan inverse of 56 divided by 33. We got tan inverse of 56 divided by 33. So that is tan inverse of 56 divided by 33. We need to prove that is same as cos inverse of 33 by 65. So consider another one triangle. Mark one angle, y. Tan y is 56 by 33. This is opposite side. This is adjacent side. Then by using Pythagoras property, you will get this as 65. So you can write tan inverse of 56 by 33 as, means tan y is 56 by 33. So cos y is 33 by 65. So y is cos inverse of 33 by 65. So tan inverse of 56 by 33 is same as cos inverse of 33 by 65. Clear? So like this, questions are very important. You have to practice more. Very nice now to do. Yes. Prove that cot inverse of root of 1 plus sin x plus root 1 minus sin x divided by root of 1 plus sin x minus root 1 minus sin x is equal to x by 2. How we can do this one? See this 1 plus sin x. 1 plus sin x we can write it as cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. Check it. A plus b whole square. A square. That means cos square x by 2 plus 2ab. 2 into cos x by 2 into sin x by 2 plus b square. That is sin square x by 2. Cos square x by 2 and sin square x by 2. Cos square x by 2 plus sin square x by 2 will come 1. Plus 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. So 2 sin theta cos theta we can write as sin 2 theta. So 2 into x by 2 we are getting it as x. So we can write 1 plus sin x as cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. Same way, 1 minus sin x we can write it as cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 whole square. So we are starting from the left hand side. Cot inverse of, I am replacing root of 1 minus sin x with the cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. Root of cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. So 1 plus sin x, 1 plus sin x replaced with this one. So root of 1 plus sin x will come cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 plus root of 1 minus sin x. 1 minus sin x is cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 whole square. So taking root, that square will cancel. So we are getting cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 on the numerator. Denominator will come root of 1 plus sin x is cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 minus cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2.
Then cot inverse of cos x by 2 plus cos x by 2, we are getting 2 cos x by 2 on the numerator, plus sin x by 2 and minus sin x by 2 cancel. Then while removing the bracket, it will come minus cos x by 2 and plus sin x by 2 in the next step. Cos x by 2 and minus sin x by 2 cancel. Sin x by 2 plus sin x by 2, it is coming 2 sin x by 2. Okay. Then it is equal to 2, 2 cancelled. Cot inverse of cos x by 2, cos by sin is cot. So we are getting cot x by 2. So it is equal to cot inverse of cot x by 2 means x by 2. That interval is given, means within the interval only these all problems are coming for us. So it is given x by 2. We got it as x by 2, that is our right hand side, given the proof. Understood?
Our question was root of 1 plus sin x. We replaced 1 plus sin x with cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. So square root of square will come. So it cancelled. We got cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 plus, like this we got. And short form we got it as cos x by 2 by sin x by 2, that is cot x by 2. Finally we got it as x by 2. Got the idea? Okay. Then, or you can do like this also. Numerator by denominator form. Denominator's conjugate you can take and you can multiply on the numerator and denominator with the denominator's conjugate. Then simplify inside the bracket. Finally, you will get like this cot x by 2. Then x by 2. Okay. Little more lengthy it will come. Like this, this is very beautiful actually. That one also you will get it. Some more steps extra will come. That much only. Okay. So, this much only I am discussing today. So, we are winding up this lesson actually. The balance questions you have to do alone and ask the doubts. Before doing the exercise question, go through all the example questions. You have to work out all the example questions by yourself. Then after doing the example question, do every question from the exercise and a miscellaneous question, miscellaneous exercise. Okay. So our inverse trigonometry chapter is over. So next day we will start new chapter. Before that you complete all the works. Okay. Today or tomorrow you take to complete the exercise questions. Okay. Bye.